الحمد لله خالق الوجود من العدم وجاعل النور من الظلم ومخرج الصبر من الألم فملقي التوبة على الندم فنشكره على المصائب كما نشكره على النعم ونصلي على رسوله الأكرم ذي الشرف الأشم والنور الأتم والكتاب المحكم وكمال النبيين والخاتم سيدي ولدي آدم الذي بشر به عيسى بن مريم ودعا لبعثته إبراهيم عليه السلام حين كان يرفع قواعد بيت الله المحرم فصلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى أتباعه خير الأمم الذين بارك الله بهم كافة الناس العرب منهم والعجم فالحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا والحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا والحمد لله الذي نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا فصلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار قال الله عز وجل في كتابه الكريم بعد أن أقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ ثُمَّ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ اللَّهُمَّ لَا تَجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْرِضِينَ رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَاحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِّسَانِي يَفْقَهُوا قَوْلِي اللَّهُمَّ ثَبِّتْنَا عِندَ الْمَوْتِ بِلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ اللهم اجعلنا من الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر آمين يا رب العالمين. At a previous occasion, I've spoken to you extensively about an ayah from Surah Al-Ahzab, and that ayah is about speaking clearly. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. And I talked about the benefits of that particular ayah and what we can take away in our lives from it. So speaking clearly is one directive in the Quran. But speaking beautifully is another separate directive in the Quran. And that's what I'm going to speak to you about today, and the importance of beautiful speech and what it actually means and how that can better our lives if we just take this one thing that Allah has said and implement it. And in fact, it's not just something that benefits you and I, but if we fail to implement it, it brings a lot of chaos into life. And so we're going to look at how that can affect your life and mine, and how we can perhaps protect ourselves from the damage it can do. So I want to start with something called iltifat. Iltifat means there is a sudden, all of a sudden change. So for example, if I'm talking to one person and all of a sudden I stop talking to them and I start talking to somebody else. So I did iltifat from this person to that person. Or I could do an iltifat of a subject. I was talking to you about cars and all of a sudden I started talking to you about the weather. That would be iltifat. There's a kind of iltifat in the Quran. It's done very, very strategically. Sometimes Allah talks about some people and that's called the third person. So He's talking about them and they and the Israelites or whoever, in this particular case, the Israelites. And all of a sudden, in the same ayah, by the time He gets to the end of the ayah, He's not saying they, He's saying you. So there's a switch from they to you. And that's a big switch. When you're talking to somebody and you're saying, I heard about them, they did this, they did this, they did this, you did this. You switched over from them to you. Those are two different groups, right? So what happens in this ayah that I'm about to share with you, the 83rd ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, is one, this kind of iltifat. And I want your attention on that because part of what we're going to learn has to do with this iltifat, this deliberate thing that Allah does in the Quran, this transition. So He says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when we took the covenant, the promise from the children of Israel, that you shall not worship anyone other than Allah, and you will be the best you can possibly be with both your parents. So he's talking about what he said to them. You won't worship anyone other than Allah. You will be the best you can be to your parents and to close relatives and to the orphans and to those who can't help themselves, al-masakin. And you shall speak to people, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا, and speak to people in the most beautiful way. Speak to people beautifully. That's what he told them. Speak to people kindly, beautifully, in a good way. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ, and establish above and beyond all of that, establish the prayer, maintain the prayer, preserve the prayer, and give the charity that it's due to be given, the zakah. Then, so this started, all of this started with, they were given this promise. Then he says, then after that, I'll expect Allah to say, then after Allah took this promise from them, they turned away. Right? Because he took it from them, and they turned away. He says, thumma, instead of me hearing thumma tawallaw illa qalilan minhum wa hum mu'ridun, qal thumma tawallaytum illa qalilan minkum wa antum mu'ridun. You turned away except for very few among you, while all of you were purposefully ignoring what was taught. All of you were deliberately ignoring. So we went from they to you. Now this is important for the Israelites, because when Allah gave them this, that was many, even though this is the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Allah gave them this instruction, it was given to them through Musa alayhi salam. That was thousands of years ago, even for them. And they've had many generations since then, and the Jewish community that the Quran is speaking to in Medina is actually thousands of years and many generations apart from the community from whom this promise was taken, the original children of Israel. You know, the ones that were given the Sharia of Musa alayhi salam. So what did Allah do? Allah, in one ayah, He spanned several centuries, He spanned several generations, and basically told them the same thing that was told to them. It's understood that it applied to all of you. And it's unfortunate that you people turned away. You people turned away. So Allah is making them concerned not with what the people in the past did, but what they're doing. ثُمَّ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. Now this becomes a direct criticism of the people that were actually alive and listening to the Prophet ﷺ. This isn't just, oh, the Israelites were given something and they didn't follow it in the past. He brought it into the present. And in doing so, he taught the Muslims something. That when Allah criticizes even those who made mistakes in history, or who were given a responsibility in history, but he switches it over across thousands of years to the present, that's the mindset I'm supposed to have towards the Quran. The words are alive, and I better, if Allah had blessed those people with revelation and they ignored it, then now Allah has blessed you and me with revelation. Are we ignoring it? And if we are ignoring it, then we're not that different from those same people that Allah criticizes and He calls them Banu Israel. And we're modeling the same behavior. So in doing so, Allah has given me a formula, right? And it's a pretty scary one. That if I behave, my attitude is the same as them, then I'm no different than them. The ones that Allah criticizes. Now having said all of that, look at the instructions inside of this ayah. They're the same ones we have in Islam. Don't worship anybody other than Allah. Be the best you can be to your parents. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدِينِ إِحْسَانًا. Then he says, after you're the best to your parents, then he goes on to, you know, وَذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ, closest relatives. After closest relatives, orphans. After orphans, those that are poor, those who can't help themselves. Now there's a progression. The closest one to you is Allah. You're the best to Allah. When you're the best to Allah, then the first demonstration of that is how you are going to be with your parents, the best you can possibly be. And if you have developed this gratitude to Allah and this appreciation of your parents and the excellence towards them, then it's not just, I'm good to my parents, but I hate my uncles. But I'm really good to my mom and dad, but my cousins, man, if they show their face. No, that transitions over to how you deal with others.